Hey everybody, so as you probably know, I am a pretty big fan of theme parks, and I go to theme parks pretty often and regularly. But today I'm going to go to a theme park in Queensland that I've only been before once, and only once, and that was almost 10 years ago, and that's Aussie World. So I went to Aussie World in 2013 with my family, and I think it's probably Australia's most overlooked amusement park, really. It's not as well known as like Dream World or Movie World or Sea World or even Luna Park in Sydney. And it is around the size of Luna Park Sydney. It's a lot smaller than the major parks and has fewer rides. They're smaller. I mean, I wouldn't say it's a bad park or like it has like really cheap low quality rides. That there are a few good quality rides there, but it is a smaller business compared to the Gold Coast theme parks. But anyway, I've decided to take my camera along today and film the sights and sounds and anything that might be interesting there. The last time I went there, I wanted to go on that wooden wild mouse that I saw them have, and it looked pretty fun. It kind of looked similar to the one that was at Luna Park Sydney. But when I went there, it was closed, and now it's demolished. So I haven't really looked up the park recently, but I have heard there's like a new steel wild mouse where the old one used to be, but I'm not entirely sure. I'm going into this park kind of blind, try not to look up too much about it because I want to kind of just see, discover if there's anything new there for myself. So I'll take you along and I'll show you what I can find there. Okay, so I have now arrived at Aussie World, and it looks pretty cool. I was actually right about that steel wild mouse. It actually is here. It's you can't see it from this angle, but I'll be sure to show you when I get inside. The scary maze, the mayhem maze. It's a scary maze kind of themed to like a mental asylum, and it was good. It was a little bit scary. It was very short though. It only went for like 3 minutes, and when I was lining up, the first group went in and they came out like 10 minutes later. I'm thinking, man, this might be actually a bit long, but no, I got through in like 3 minutes. But yeah, it was good. Okay, so something I've just noticed here is that there's a small pirate ship right here, and probably if I'm wrong here, but it looks exactly like the one that used to be at the My Center in the 90s. I mean, I've seen certain videos of tops on YouTube, and they have this pirate ship there, and it looks like the exact same as it is right here than it does in the video. So. I mean, it's not operating today, but maybe if somebody knows more about it, maybe you can let me know, I don't know, in the comments. Yeah, it definitely looks like the same one, very similar looking model at least.
I'm winning! I'm winning! Oh my god! some remains of the old cars on the original Wild Mouse Coaster that they used to have here, which I unfortunately never was able to get on. But, oh well.
So yeah, I have a feeling that this one is definitely down for maintenance, and probably even that that claw like 360 swinger ride behind it as well. I mean, there's no maintenance down for maintenance signs in front of the actual entrances of the rides themselves, but there was one further down the hill, so I'm not entirely sure if it's down for maintenance or not. I have to maybe wait maybe another hour or something, but if both those rides are down, I'd say it's a bit of a bummer, because it seems like those two rides are definitely the main draw cards for this park. I did just get off the Redback, and that I think those two rides and that one are definitely the three main rides of the park. And you've got the log ride, but yeah, it seems like only like half the stuff is open today, which is a bit of a bummer. They didn't really tell that on the website, but oh well.
Okay, so that ride, the SX360, is now open. The Wild Mouse roller coaster called the Dingo Racer actually is not under maintenance. It actually isn't open yet. So I think it's going to be open maybe a couple of months or something. But yeah, it's basically like the claw, this ride, but it actually goes all the way upside down. So it should be pretty exciting, pretty scary. So let's go.
Okay, so I just came off SX360, and yeah, it was a really good ride actually. I mean, the first thing it reminds you of is the claw at Dream World, except this thing goes all the way upside down. Though, it only does it once though. I was expecting it to maybe go up or down maybe two or three times before it slowed down, but it only does it once. I did go on a ride at the Ecker once that did that, but it did it a couple more times. But yeah, it's really good, pretty intense. Though I felt the sense of speed was a bit more controlled compared to the claw. The claw was a bit more, felt a bit more out of control. But anyway, yeah, I'll probably give the ride a 7 out of 10. Definitely the best ride here at Aussie World, and I'll probably go on it one more time before I leave today. All right, so I just got off the Retro Rocket, which is in this building behind me, and I'll tell you one thing, that ride did not feel safe. I mean, like, it was jittery, it was bumpy, it felt completely out of control. It's kind of like this, kind of like those spinny things that you see in the fun fairs. Actually, they have one over there as well, but like you're on like these spinning cars and you're up and down and up and down inside this building. It was lots of fun. It was pretty noisy too, so if loud noise bothers you, maybe just put in some earplugs or something, but it was good. A really good ride. It'd be my last ride of the day before I'm probably going to hang out at the Enemuga pub for maybe about 10-20 minutes, have something to eat, maybe have a drink before I drive home. But yeah, I've really enjoyed my day at Aussie World. It's kind of surprised me in ways, because I wasn't expecting much, but they do have quite a lineup here, and it is a growing park. It definitely didn't have this much when I came here 10 years ago. I also tried the Illusionarium too, and that was fun too. It's more for the kids, but it's kind of like a mini infinity attraction. And there's some pretty cool illusions in there, so if that's something that you're interested in, definitely give it a try. Anyway, I'm gonna leave now and begin the drive home.
Okay, so I'm now back from Aussie World. I've got a bit of sunburnt again. I always forget to put sunscreen on. I'll remember next time. But anyway, yeah, I had a pretty good time today. General consensus of Aussie World is that it's a bit too small, that there's not too much to do. But I was pretty surprised of how much stuff was actually there, and a few new things that have gone up since I went there last. And the Retro Rocket kind of took me by surprise of just how I mean, that one was actually pretty intense, pretty forceful, and it was completely indoors. There was like lasers and lights and music and stuff like that. And I also enjoyed their scary maze that they had, even though it was really short. But most scary mazes are, even the ones at Movie World, go for about 5 minutes. And there was an illusion exhibit, which kind of felt a bit like Infinity, though Infinity is of course much bigger than what that was. But it had one of those spinning tunnel illusions, and it was actually a really convincing one. I actually felt like the platform was moving, and I've been through several through different places, and I've never really been through one that felt that convincing or intense. So I was pretty impressed by that. I went to the Edamuga pub, but I don't think it's called that anymore. It's called like the Mango Bar or something. They made it look more tropical. I guess that kind of makes sense because Sunshine Coast is a tropical area, and they were probably, even though the Edamuga pub is supposed to be like really Australian, I think they're trying to make it more Queensland-like, which makes sense. That roller coaster still isn't open. I haven't really been following its construction of this particular ride, but I feel like it's been up there since 2020. There's a big sign out the front that it was built as like a tourist development surplus to get more tourists to the Sunshine Coast. And it's probably, you know, COVID's probably has really slowed down and even halted that construction, as it's done with Leviathan at SeaWorld. And but overall, I was pretty surprised by Aussie World. I mean, I was expecting it to be kind of subpar, a bit lacking. And even though it was lacking, it was good for what it was. It's not supposed to be a big theme park. The SX360 is a really good thrill ride, and it's a really, really neat addition to the park. It really brings those thrill seekers to the park. And overall, I had fun. There's a mini golf course there. There's a bunch of kids rides that the kids can go on, and the more intense rides for the older kids and the teens and the adults. And overall, I think I'm going to give it a nice, solid 6 out of 10. So if you haven't been to Aussie World before, I'm not like screaming that it's a must go or it's a must, but you should definitely check it out if you're near it. And though I didn't really agree with the price, I thought the entry price of $45 was a little bit too much. I mean, like, of course, like Dream World and Movie World costs like $80 to $90 for their tickets. I still think that's a bit too expensive, even for that. I just get the pass so I can just buy it once and be able to go whenever I want throughout the year. But overall, I would say maybe a max of $30 would be the absolute highest you would pay to go into Aussie World. And they also give you like this, they offer this, if you pay $12 more, you get like a free card for 3 sideshow games, which I actually forgot to use while I was there. I was too distracted going on all the big rides. But anyway, it is a pretty decent place, and definitely one that's worth checking out. So I hope you've enjoyed this vlog. If you have enjoyed it, definitely let me know in the comments below, and I'll try and make some more. And I'll see you in the next one. Take care.